Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today I'm going to show you how to size the bearings on a 2008 Yamaha R6 motor. Now I'm assuming that you're already down and you're looking at the guts of your motor. All you need to know is how to size the bearings. That's what I'm going to show you. But before I do that, here's the three things you need to get together. And it's basically numbers off of the block, the crankshaft itself, and then on the connector rods. So once you've got those written down somewhere, we can get started. All right, guys, this is going to be a skill level 2, and I'm really not going to go through any tools because that's not really what we're discussing here. What we're wanting to figure out is what specific bearings are going to be required for your particular engine. All right, once I show you how to do that, then you can go to our website, look at our drawing, which is a crankshaft with the pistons, and then it'll show you the different ones that can be chosen from. And once I show you how to actually choose the right ones, then you can order those. So if you're ready, let me show you how to do it. All right, guys, let's talk about bearing sizing. If you did have to replace the connector rod, or if you were replacing your crank because it was damaged, then you would have to size your bearings from scratch. First thing you want to note is the number that is stamped on the end of your crankshaft. So you want to write that down. With that information, when you're sizing just your connector rod bearings, it's the last four numbers that we read off, which was 1221 on my crankshaft. So what you would do is look on the ends of each one of your connector rods, and there's going to be a number. In my case, it's 5H, 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 5H. So they're all the same. So it's going to be 5 minus 1 gives you a 4, which is a green. So the next number would be a 5 minus 2, which would be 3, which will give you a brown. As far as the sizing for the mains, you want to look on the back side of your engine on the lower half of the crankcase, and there can be as little as one number right here. Mine happens to be a 5. What that tells me is it's the same across the board. All these different journal locations are a 5. So we compare that over to our crank, which has a 2. So for each one of these, it's going to be the same bearing. So it's going to be 5 minus the 2 minus another 1. So that gives you, or in my case, it gives me a 2, which according to the chart signifies a black bearing, which in fact, that's exactly what I have, or what came out of here. You can barely see on that edge where they had marked this. So that little black section, that signifies this as being a black bearing, and that's indeed what the chart told us. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. Well, listen, if you need to see how to rebuild the entire engine, why don't you look at some of our other videos, and I can show you how to get that done. Now that you've actually done the sizing and you're sure about the part numbers, why don't you go find us over at Partzilla.com, and we can get you taken care of. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.